Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today, we're gonna do temples with Sculptra, and I'm gonna show you the injection technique that I use. There's many different techniques. The nice part about Sculptra is the carriers of water. It's very unique. When you pull back, if you're in a vessel, it's easier to see than if you were in a gel product. The other thing is longevity. The less you have to inject a temple, the safer it is. If you have to do it every 6 months, that adds a danger factor. So temples are part of the frame of the face, very important to a natural lip. Lifts the edge of the eye, and patients love the results. Let's go, we'll watch the video now. So getting Sculptra mixed, you put air into it, and you have to do this before injection, because if you look at the ones that I lie down, they have Sculptra in the bottom, and when you inject that, that's a nodule. People cause nodules, Sculptra does not. And it's because not putting air in it before you inject, mixing it like that, it will not come out. Getting the air out, putting a ball of fluid in the top, putting it on tight, making sure it works. And then you can inject. So here we're filling the temple, feeling the zygomatic bone stabilizing the face. On the patient's left, you try and inject just like on the patient's right, so you have to change your mindset a little bit. It's counterintuitive. But we're coming down, pull back ever so slight. You're just looking in the hub of the needle to make sure it's clear. If there was in a vessel, if you were there, it would be very obvious because this is a liquid, it's not a gel. And so you would know immediately. And I just reposition, walk up the periosteum. Now if you get a little clog like that, you push back and inject. Push back and inject. So we're gonna try and come up here and inject just over the brow, right there. And we're gonna bolus after pulling back, but filling here will help lift the brow. Perfect, and another CC in there. And then just to hold a little bit of pressure, we like pressure. So the temple, we're using Sculptra, which is water. When you pull back on Sculptra, if you're in a vessel, you'll see it. Here's the zygomatic bone. This is the hollow we want to fill. A little poke coming here. And the periosteal plane is where I'm going to be. And you just barely touch the periosteum. You pull back so you're barely, if it's a, obviously blood is a fluid. If you pull back a little bit, it's all you need. You don't want to create a clog. And we're going to use a total of 2 mL in volume. I'm going to step up the periosteal plane just a little bit, but really if you wanted to, you can massage it all the way up too. And then it's avascular the way I do it, so you should never see more than that in terms of blood. It's really a bloodless procedure because of the injection plane above the zygomatic bone and here. That's what we teach in the courses. And the fact it's Sculptra, it's not going to wear off with movement of the temporalis like a hyaluronic acid would. It doesn't need to be repeated to that extent. So that's Sculptra in the temple. Filling the temple is part of the frame. It helps lift the eye, and especially in Europe, people like to massage that back, fill in this area, and get that towel around the head look and feel. So that's Sculptra in the temples. Oftentimes the patients don't know that they have a hollow temple and what it can do for their aesthetic look. Join us on this YouTube channel, subscribe. Also pop over to our Instagram account. We have many engaging posts and before and afters over there. Join us, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.